Alright, here is the project we're doing on this video. We are painting my sunflower. This one is my original one, painted on 11 by 14 canvas, and this one is on a 9 by 12 canvas. This is the one we're doing in the video. Little bit of differences in the leaves. So, you know, I'll show you how to do that, and you can choose to add it or not. This one's been varnished, so it's got a little bit of glare on it. There we go. Fun project. Let's get to it. Okay, so I've rolled on one coat of buttermilk onto my canvas. Now, some canvases can raise the texture on the canvas. So all you do is take a brown paper bag or a sanding pad, and I apologize if the sound of sanding is like fingernails across a chalkboard to some people. But we're going to lightly sand some of that roughness down. And then just wipe away the sanding dust. Okay, so now we're going to roll on a second coat of our buttermilk. So we're just going to do this very quickly. And we don't have to take it all the way to the bottom. We mostly want the top of it done. And your sides. Okay, so I'm going to set this roller aside. And I'm going to get my little piece of sponge and dampen it. Which this is just a one of those mattress pad things that you put on your bed. This is one of those. So we're going to get out on our palette some burnt orange. I better shake that burnt orange up first. That is yucky yucky. Burnt orange and some yellow ochre. And so this is how we're going to do this particular technique on the background. So I'm going to load my sponge. I've got two nibs here that I have for this sponge. So I'm going to load one into the buttermilk and one into... Oh, that's not the color I wanted. Let me rinse that out. I need the yellow ochre, not the orange. Okay, so I'm going to dip into, try this again, into the buttermilk and the yellow ochre. I want those two colors on my sponge. So I'm going to go at an angle down through here with these two colors, just kind of tapping them and blending them. I went almost all the way to the corner, so I'll go up a little bit higher there. I'm going to load some more. I'm going to take my spritzing bottle and just very lightly spritz my canvas and continue on. I want these two colors to blend together. Don't want to have any kind of hard stark line. I'm just going to bring it down a little bit. More buttermilk. Now, if you want to, I think I did on one of mine, maybe on the original one, I can't remember. I think I went and wiped off or squeezed out most of the yellow ochre, and then went up in here and just kind of did a little bit of blending with that color, just pull a little bit of that color up in there, but not much. Okay, so we've got those two colors nicely. So now it is the light buttermilk that I want to try and squeeze out of my sponge here. Or if you have two of these, I would say grab a second one and get it damp. Now, you don't want to forget to kind of go over your edges here, you know, where you have that yellow color. So I've still got a little bit of that in my sponge there. So now I'm going to take the yellow side and dip it back into the yellow ochre. And the side that I had the buttermilk on, and dip it into the burnt orange. So now we're going to do the same thing. We're going to put the yellow down where the yellow is, and then we're going to finish up with the burnt orange. And I'm going to spritz this because I want my to be a little bit wetter. And a little bit more burnt orange. Oop, I got clear over there. Because I put just a little bit too much water on my palette, so it made it a little bit too alright, so on my other one I did bring the orange a little bit more this way. And it goes up here a little bit more, so let's bring it up some. Blend it in with that yellow a little bit more. Covered up all my yellow there. I'm going to have to go back and add some more of that back in. Don't forget to do your edges down here. That orange. And then up the side where the orange is. And put the yellow. Kind of blend it out there. Now on this side we got a little bit of blending on this side, not too much. A little bit more yellow would be better. Okay, so I feel like I need more of the yellow up in here. Actually, I need a little bit more orange right in here. And you may have to come back, let this dry, and you may have to come back and repeat it, the exact same steps over. You know, this part, you don't necessarily have to do that part, but, you know, put the light buttermilk and the yellow on your sponge. I really want this to be much darker down here in this corner. So I'm going to get a little bit more orange. Oops. And just kind of tap that in there. Okay, too much yellow there. But I want a nice gradation of color. So if you're not seeing a gradation of color, let it dry and then come back and redo it. I'm going to wash my sponge out because I really feel like I need more yellow through there. I feel like I've got a curve instead of a straight line. So I'm going to wash my sponge out. Wring it out. Get the excess water out as best I can here. Got a little bit of orange up there. So I'm going to go back into my buttermilk and antique gold, yellow ochre here. A little bit more yellow ochre here. That bottle might be done for. This one's about done for too. Just a little bit more yellow ochre. I want a little straighter line here. That's not even very straight. Okay, there we go. Now I'm going to start blending that line out. buttermilk in there, blending it out. It's a very fun technique for a background. And you can just use so many color variations with it. So there we've got a nice color change there. I like that. Alright, I'm going to get out of it because if I don't, it will start picking up the paint because the paint is starting to dry. So if you find that it is doing that, let it dry and come back with a second coat. Okay, our background's dry. I've traced the pattern on. Very lightly trace it on with graphite. The leaves and stuff down here don't matter so much, but our sunflowers matter a little bit because, you know, we don't want to have to try and cover up those graphite lines. I'm going to leave mine like they are for you so that you can see them. But we're going to base in each petal with Sunny Day. It's called Sunny Day. I really like this color. A lot of times yellows, moon yellow is a yellow that is more opaque. And this one is too, and that's what I like about it. That it's a little bit more opaque. So it's not going to take near as much paint to cover what we need to cover. Now, I am doing each petal very carefully, individually, so that we can see where they are. And if we need to, when we get all of our petals base coated, if we need to go back in and add some graphite lines, if we can't particularly tell where our graphite lines are, then we can go back in and add those to show the separation of our petals. The most time-consuming things are going to be petals, obviously, because we really want to take our time and really give them the detail that they deserve. We don't want to rush them and, you know, not. We want to try and get it as realistic looking as you can. Your own pace. I can tend to be a fast painter. Don't feel like you have to keep up with me. You can stop this video and paint what you need to paint and then come back to it. So I don't know how well you can see. Let me zoom in just a little bit. But I can see all of my graphite lines here. We're going to be doing quite a bit of shading and highlighting and stuff in here. So these in here will more than likely get covered up. But these out here on the outer edge, when I come back with my second coat, I've got to really try to make sure the ones that I have put paint on to get them covered good. Because once you put paint on them, they are on there. They are set. Can't do anything with it. But if you haven't gotten paint on the graphite, you can come back and erase it. So I believe on my original one, I transferred the design on with white graphite, and I tried it on here, but I just could not get it to show up enough with the white. So oops. I am going to go off camera and finish base coating these in because it's just all simple base coating. I'm using a number 8 flat brush. If you are doing yours on a larger canvas, then you can definitely use a larger brush. I think this particular one, I'm going to give it a little bit of curl at the end. Make it a little bit more spectacular. Now, I don't know how many of you have had the fortune to be up close and see a big sunflower field. We have a few close by where I live, but I've only seen them from the road driving by. I grew up in Kansas, but where I grew up in Kansas, we didn't have sunflower fields. And it is the state flower of Kansas, but so I have only seen them in pictures. And I wanted to take our grandkids out to the big sunflower fields and take their pictures, but never got that done. So maybe next year I can get that done, because I think that would make some really nice pictures. Alright, so just simple base coating here, keeping each petal on its individual basis so that you can tell where it is later. But if you can't, then go back and lightly add some lines in to separate your leaves, your petals. And don't forget to base coat in your bud over here as well. Now you'll just need a small round brush to do that. Alright, I'm gonna finish this one up, base coat this in, get my second coats on. Alright, I'm finishing up my second coats, and I really wanted to come back and point out to you that not all of these are petals over here. The petals in the back are in the back, and up here in the front, all this in the front is the calyx. So that's kind of hard to tell on the design there, on the line drawing. Okay, so that's two coats of our sunny day yellow. Alright, so we're going to work on our petals instead of getting all of our base coats in. And then we'll come in and base coat all of our other stuff. I know in my instructions it lists the base coats first. So you have that option to go ahead and put all of your base coats on. Base coat your leaves and your stem and your center and just get that done. For me on this video, I'm going to work it like I would be teaching a class, and I am going to concentrate just on the petals for now. Alright, all my base coats are done here, so now we're going to start adding some color on our petals. And I'm going to use a flat brush. This is all I used in my original painting. I might go down to a size 8 flat. But you can also use a curved flat if you have them. This is a discontinued brush, but I still have a few of these two sizes on my website. And you can always use, you know, an angle brush if you prefer to use an angle brush. So whenever you shade or highlight, the brush type really depends on you and what you love to use. There's no right or wrong brush that you can pick. So I'm going to stay with my 10 flat. It might be a little big. I might have to go down a size. So we'll see. We're going to start adding some lines. I kind of drew my petal lines in here a little bit and erased them back just so that you could see where they lay. I really didn't want to have any of the dark color on there, but I needed you to see where they are. So we're going to start by adding some lines in our leaves or our petals. So we're going, first of all, I don't know if I told you when I was painting this, but you have to wake up your brushes. So you put them in the water. You put them in your water basin, excuse my dirty, ugly water basin, and you just let the bristles fill up with water. I just kind of, you know, push them against the side and let them fill up and plump up, okay? And probably most of you know this if you watch any of my videos, but I like to do it in case there's someone new. You just go lay it on your paper towel, both sides, and it wicks out the excess water, so it's got the right amount of water to start going and painting for you. The bristles are awake, they're plump. They're ready to go. The other thing that I like to do when I float is to spritz my palette paper with water. So I do it all along that side right there. Get it where you can see it. And there'll be all different kinds of sizes of water drops on there. There we go. You can see all the different sizes. The more you spray in one spot, the bigger your water drops are. But then on the edge that I don't have paint generally, sometimes I will pick it up on the paint size. I'll pick up paint right there, and I will go and work it into my brush just like I would my paint. Okay? So when I load the float, I load like this, just kind of in a back and forth motion, because you need to get it worked in on both sides, not just one. If you prefer to load like this, that's perfectly fine. That is awkward for me, and I don't like to do it that way. So I always tell you to load your brush, to use the brush that you like, to load your brush the way that you like. But if you need suggestions, I'm always here on my videos showing you the way that I do it, so it can help you out in your painting. So we want to paint some strokes or some just lines in our petals, and we'll do a couple kind of coming up in here. If you've got a smaller petal, then you don't have to do it. You don't have to do two. You could just do one. If it's a really big petal, you could do three. I'm trying to look at my original one and see how I did them. So this is my original painting, and some of them I did a couple. Okay, and some of the smaller ones, I just did one. Okay, so you'll want to do it like that. So just, and you don't have to start all the way down at the base of the petal, but you certainly can. You could start down here and have it go the shape of the petal, and kind of go up. And so this one I might do a third little line over here, although you can't see it because there was so much water on the edge of my brush. It just completely washed that out. This one back here, we'll just do one. And this one might have a piece of one coming up. So again, this is with golden straw. And it's really important that you load both sides of your brush when you are loading your brush. Even when you go to reload, do it on both sides. And when you pick up water, you need to work it into your brush exactly like you would work the paint in. Just don't pick up water and then come over to your project and, you know, paint with it, because it's not going to work well. You'll just be laying down a lot of water and it will just wash your paint right off. This one back here, I think I could get probably two on it. No, it's not a turned leaf. So I just did a little piece of a second one there. Let me zoom you in. I don't want to zoom in too much because I want to keep the whole flower on the camera, in the camera shot. So when I'm away from here, I am reloading my brush. I try to stay in that same spot until it feels dry. And when it starts feeling dry, then I am going to move to a different spot on my palette. So we just do this all around. Take your time. Don't feel like you have to rush it. Okay, that one got a little bit dark. Just a scooch dark. Golden straw is what we're using. I don't know if I've said that. I probably did. I probably even called it a different color. You really want to try and keep these kind of soft. I've got them a little bit dark on here, so try and keep them a little bit on the softer edge, a lighter color, and that way if you need to, you can come back and add some color on here, but you can't take it away. You just have to base coat over it and start over. Probably should have gone with a little bit smaller brush because this canvas is smaller than my original canvas. This is a turned petal here. Okay, so here we have some smaller petals on top of the bigger one. So the bigger one here is here, and the smaller one is here. One of them. There's three of them. Pick up a little bit of water and blend that in. And then we've got one. I think I originally drew it there, but I didn't want it right next to my the edge of that other petal. Got one here. This one we can just put one in. A little bit in these. They don't need too much. And then our other one here. We can put a couple little ones in there. Okay, so that's got our initial color in there. And these over here, we don't have to do those because, you know, they're the back side of the petals and they're kind of turned up. Okay, so now we're going to shade in the center of these petals. Okay, we're going to start shading in the center of these. Gotta let my paint dry here. We're gonna mix golden straw and orange twist. So I am going to dip once into orange twist, dip once into golden straw, and just kind of mix them. I think I might add a little bit more orange twist. Now I want to really work this in my brush so it softens. I want it to soften here on my palette so that I know that's how it's going to come out on my brush, so I'm just working it with the water that's in my brush. So you see it's got a transparent tint to it. I'll touch the very tip of my brush to my paper towel, and then we're going to go in here and start adding some of this down in here on each one of our petals. and we want to keep this soft, so we can actually keep it more in between the two. It's been a while since I painted this project, so I'm trying to make a video for it now. So you see here, I did it more in between where I put those lines on there. So we'll try and keep it more in that general area. So we'll do this on all of our petals. Just brush mix it. Don't overthink it. But you do need to kind of work it with some water. Keep it kind of more on the lighter side. We can always come back and darken this, but we don't want to have it too dark to start out with. Put a little bit back here on these. Here, we could put just a scooch down in there. We'll probably shade down in there so we won't see that down in there anyway. So when I am doing this, I am basically making a C stroke. So let me get some scrap paper here and I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm basically making a C stroke. So I'm loading my brush here. I am kind of making a C stroke in between those lines and then just kind of walking it up a little bit. So let's say my line is here and here. I'm going to just kind of try and keep this in between those lines and just walk it up a little bit till it, focus, there we go, until it fades away just a little bit, okay? Work it into your brush, make it soft. This one needs a little bit more, I think. Like I said, we can always come back and repeat this. So, I would rather that you had a lighter touch than a heavier touch. Brush mix. I'm working a little bit more into my brush here when I'm off the camera, just the same way that I showed you. You can take this all the way down to the center there. It doesn't have to be not at the center. Up at the top here, so now we can look at it and see if we need to adjust and add any more. Or any of the petals that you think missed this one, so let me do it. So some of these look like they could use a little bit more on them. So I'm going to mix a little bit more here on my brush. Soften it out. Touch my paper towel because I felt like there was a lot of stuff going on there with my brush. Water and paint, like I had just a scooch too much. One down closer to the center. A little bit there, a little bit here, a little bit more on my brush. And I didn't put any line on this one here, so let me do that. Wipe my brush out here and get some golden straw. Here, I'll just put one line there. Okay, so we've got the beginnings of our centers there, of our petals. Okay, so now let's take our golden straw, and we are going to begin our shading of this, where one petal lays on top of another petal. This is where we're going to put this. So, like this petal here that is turned lays over that petal. So we're going to take our golden straw and shade those areas. We'll come back and do the other side where this petal lays on that one as well. So kind of next to the petals that are on top of each other. I need more water in my brush on the paint side. This is with golden straw. Okay, where are we at here? Now this petal lays on top of two petals, or three petals here. So we want to go around it. My pencil line is pretty dark there, and I probably just got too much paint on it in order to erase it. Okay, so this one here. This is my petal here, my center one. So we want to go around that one so we can bring it more forward. Okay, and this is another one that kind of lays on top here, our other little one. And we don't have to have our petals be so controlled and perfectly shaped. So, like this one. Maybe I want it to come up here and be a little more wiggly. I can do that. The same with this one. We can give it a long tip. When we highlight, we can adjust that. And this one, I don't really want my petals to be so perfect. So on this one, you see how I made them have a little bit of imperfection and wiggles, and you know, I don't want perfect petals. So I don't want you to try and make yours perfect either. So try to be a little bit more loose with your strokes there. Just have fun with it. This is traditional decorative painting all the way. So, for that one. I'm over here working on these now. Let's see. This one. And this one. A little wiggly wig. Oops. and do this side here that we missed. Go around there. So any of them that you feel like you've missed, definitely need paint and water here. And you can just go and do those real quick. The ones that you feel like you've missed putting a little bit of shading on, that's just our initial shading, so we've got more to do here. Okay, we're going to start adding some highlighting on here. We're going to add some Snow White. Okay, so we're going to do all of our tips of our petals and with some Snow White. And let's see. I'm going to bring this down a little bit. We are also going to do, which I see now, I had my brush turned the wrong direction because the shading should be on the outside of these. We want to highlight along these as well. So all of your tips. Try not to cover them up though. This is Snow White, don't worry. We're going to be putting some washes on here so we don't have this bright white showing up. But we needed some light stuff going on here. So what I would recommend you doing is going around and doing kind of all of your tips and maybe kind of the outer edges just a little bit. And then by the time you get back around, the edges will be dry and you can come in and do your center lines. So we'll do all of our tips first. And we need to go over here and do some shading on those before we do white on them. So you see how we're starting to create a little bit of... I know the white, when you put the white on here, it's like, whoa. Not really digging that white, but it will all be fine in the end. Do not worry. I would not lead you astray, I promise. I promise, I promise, I promise. And use the size of brush that you are most comfortable using. I have a rather large brush here that I probably should be using something a little bit smaller. I am a determined painter. So I have no doubt I can get it done with this. I am going to control the brush. I'm not going to let the brush control me. You mostly want to concentrate on the very tips of the petals. But we do need a little bit where, you know, you kind of separate the petals. We're going to be adding some shading back in there, so. This is mostly tip stuff. And this gives you an opportunity to shape your petals however you would like to see them shaped. So that one wasn't even curved that way, but I took my paint and pushed it out and curved it a little bit. We have a light enough background that we can do that. And I kind of messed that one up. Erase that. Erase, erase, erase. Just a damp brush. I've got my yellow paint way out there, so I'm trying to cover it up. Put a little bit of this down here. I know, I'm telling you, when I painted my first one, that white one, I put it on, I'm like, okay. Not really sure how that is going to work out or help. Probably have just a touch too much water in my brush. My white might end up fading back in there too much. So try not to overfill your brush with water when you're floating on these. Give your petals some character there. And don't make them all so perfect. No two paintings will be alike. Yours will not look like mine. Mine will not even look like my original. So, okay, so I've done all of my tips. So now I'm going to go in and add some of this along my lines that I put in there, which my lines should have been reversed, so I might have to come back and redo that. I'll show you what I mean when I get this white on here. I'm sure you'd probably like to be on camera. So you see, I'm going along the outside, so my shading color, which was the golden straw, needs to be on the inside. So you're going along those initial lines. The very first thing that we did on these. Okay, I think I got them all. So let me show you what I mean when I say I have them backwards. So I'm going to take my golden straw. And so the white is on that side. The golden straw should have floated on the inside. So you would want to go around and do all of one side with this color, and then come back and do the other side. Now that I probably have you completely and utterly confused, the water edge should remain towards the center. So now I'm going to flip my brush over and I'm going to paint the opposite side towards the middle. I will probably come back and add a little bit of that white highlight back on here. Next to those lines. I'm trying to see my lines now. I can't see them. So I'm just going to do the ones that I can tell that I can see. Alright, I'm going to wash my brush off and go get some more of that white. Straight white. And come along here. Go down one side. Then flip your brush over and do the other side. So when I put that color back in there in the center, kind of covered up a little bit of my highlights. Come along and do the other side. Miss that one. Not in the center. Got my white paint going everywhere on my palette over here. Be sure and use your clean water, which is the water that you sprayed on your palette. Okay. There we go. That's how our highlights and our shading should look. Not like I had it before. Okay, I'm going to come over here and do this small one over here. I'm going to shade it with that mix. Golden Straw and Orange Twist. So we'll shade the petals at the bottom. Kind of figure out where they are. Okay. We'll come back and deepen that. Go ahead and add our highlight on the tips with the white. I might separate my petals a little bit here. So we're kind of starting to see where our petals are. There with that. Deepen that let's deepen the shade in here. Just mixing a little bit on my brush here. So I'm just repeating it so that I can deepen it. We got those caught up now because they don't have any lines in them that we have to worry about. Okay, so well, over here we do need to shade a little bit on some of these where with just the Golden Straw. Okay, that looks good. All right, we are going to wash over like the petals that are in the back with, what are we doing? Let's do yellow, see what yellow ochre looks like. We can use yellow ochre or Golden Straw. I have them both on my palette list. So my yellow ochre feels kind of not shook up, so let me shake it up here. Okay, so I'm going to do one with yellow ochre, and if I don't think it's dark enough, then I'll go in some Golden Straw, but yellow ochre is actually darker, so, but it's a paler yellow, where that's a more golden yellow. So we're just going to create a little wash. It's mostly water with a little bit of color in there. So we're going to do our back petals. Okay. I am going to see how the Golden Straw looks, because I think the Golden Straw will keep them more yellow. I don't really like that yellow ochre is this yellow ochre off. So we're going to use just the Golden Straw. So you're going to take some water and put a little bit of paint in it. and just go onto your back petals. Oops. Wash it on there and darken those petals up just a little bit. All the ones that are behind. You just want a little bit of this. This is the sheerest of colors. So if you are laying down too much color, then you're going to want to add more water. So if it's too dark, then go pick up a damp brush and clean it off, and then add a little bit more water to your paint. You're just barely tinting some water, is all you're doing. Golden straw. And don't forget your little bud over there. We will do it the same way. Alright, look on there and see if you've got them all. Of them look like they could use a little bit more of the golden straw wash here. Okay, over here we'll do a few of these over here, the ones that are in the very back. Let's see, I think this one's in the back. Alright, now we're going to use this media fluid acrylic Hansa Yellow Light. I really want my sunflower to look like a yellow sunflower. So I'm going to take a little bit of this and make a wash of it. This is a bright color, so make sure you're making that pretty sheer. I would rather you make it so sheer that you can barely see it, as opposed to, you know, too dark that it will just take over. We are going to wash this on all of the top petals and brighten them up. This is that Hansa Yellow Light. Love this color. So all the ones that we did not put the shading on, we are going to put this color on. I love these fluid acrylics. If you haven't had a chance to use them, then you are just missing out on a lot of fun. A little bit more water here. So if you're putting it on and you can't see it, then just add a little bit more of that color in there. I think my first ones are not quite as yellow as I would like, because I want my sunflower to be yellow. Fun product. I cannot recommend these media paints enough. They are just awesome. I know you're going to love them if you try them. I just know it. Because the colors are so bright. You know, the pigment in them is just, oh, it just really, really, really pops out at you. So, oh, I see a couple of them that need just a scooch more here. These here on top. Need a little bit more of that yellow. Ooh, looking so pretty. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. Okay, so over here on our bud, we can just take a little bit of that. And the ones that are in the front, we can just put a little bit tell which ones are in the front. Okay, we're going to start darkening up our shading here just a little bit. So I'm going to get some fresh paint out here. Some orange twist and some burnt umber. We are going to create a touch darker shading on here. Spritz my palette. Okay, so we're going to take our burnt umber, because we don't want the shading to be brown, but we don't want it to be chalky either. So you're going to have more burnt umber than you're going to have orange twist. So just be aware of that. The orange twist is just lightening up that burnt umber a little bit. Okay, so we're going to add this in our darkest areas. And I'm going to get my mop brush, which I haven't used on this project, surprisingly. And I am going to mop these as I do them, because I don't want them, you know, super dark and stark. I'd rather that they stayed more soft looking. That one's a little bit darker than what I would like. So I might put a little bit of water on there and wash that down a little bit. Now it's too light, so one of those vicious circles. So we'll just keep mixing here. And adding some shading. Keep it very soft pressure, very soft. I am barely grazing my brush across this canvas. So this you'll do wherever one petal is on top of another one, and all of those petals that are in the back, you'll especially want to do them. Okay. See how we're getting some softness in here, and then we'll come back and on some of the more darker places we'll darken that up. But we want to keep this very soft, very light color. So make sure you've got some water in your brush to blend that paint with. That will help keep it soft. That's a little dark, so I'm going to take my mop brush and use my mop brush to remove it, soften it, push it back in there. So depending on how much orange straw gets mixed in there, I would say 2 to 3 burnt embers to 1 orange twist, orange twist is the color we're mixing with our burnt umber. Okay, so this one is over. And I think with this shading I can give it a little bit more. Maybe not. I'm just going to give it a little bit more movement and character there. I'm not sure that's going to work out. Alright, just loading some more, mixing some more. Soft pressure. A little bit too much paint on my brush there, so I'm going to mix a little bit of water in with that to sheer it down. I really want you to work with softer colors. So, just a little bit in your brush is all you need. Just a little bit. Soft pressure with your brush. All right. Don't forget where one lays over another one. And you get to be the judge of that. You know, you don't. You can have a different one laying on top than I have. I'm just going to bring this straight down. Put that in there. Mop it. Okay, so right here, these two look like they meet, I mean, just are touching. So, I just have to decide which one I want to be the more dominant petal. And, oops, I got my paint going the wrong direction there. So let me reload it, because I couldn't tell which side that was on my brush. So I want this one to be on top, so I'll shade right there. Alright, keep it soft, keep it soft. I'll probably say that a lot, but you'll probably get tired of me saying it, but oh, it's so important, so very important. That soft pressure in your brush. Looking good. Alright, let me pick up some water. Some more paint here. And this one is going to be on top, I think. And this one will be on top. Maybe I'm not on camera for that. We got to go under this one. And, oh, on my apron there. Let's see, where am I? Oh, up here. I gotta shade that up on the top. Okay, and then this one is on top, so you have to go back around and double check that you've got, you know, the ones that are on top are showing to be on top with a little float of color next to them. So just get those places defined. So when I'm using my finger like that, I'm just softening it almost the same way I would be if I was using my mop brush. Okay, I'm just looking at it to make sure I didn't miss any places. I'm going to go to a little bit smaller brush here so I can do my little bud over here. All right, again, try and keep this soft. Don't let it take over your petals. You'll this is such a small area here. You'll probably want to be more up on the tippy toe of your brush. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see what I'm doing here. Up on the tiptoe of your brush. And I'm not really sure which petal here is which. Okay. We can kind of go around where these leaves will be. Well, we haven't painted them in yet, so we could end up painting over our shading here. Getting a little bit more on this little brush here. Okay, so that's all we're doing on there. Stay up on your tiptoe if you can. It's wide angle out so you can see it a little bit better. Okay, so that's looking good. So now I have to decide if I want to go in and darken the shading in a few places. So I think a couple of places I will, and I'm going to use a wash of burnt umber, no orange mixed into it this time, and just pick a few places where, like in the darkest little crevices here, where you want to put some of this color. Some of these little V's in here, we can darken them up just a tiny bit. Oh, I'm telling you, just ever so tiny. All right, you don't have to do them all, just pick a few. Okay. All right, I think I might want to put a little bit more of that Hansa yellow on here. Hansa yellow light, that media paint. Now, if you don't have this color, you could probably wash over with some cad yellow or some primary yellow. I just really want to make sure that my sunflower is yellow. I think I might even take it over the back petals. I don't think I did in my original one, but I think I might take it over some of them. Because I want the ones in the front to stay in the front. Okay, we're going to add another color on here. Okay, so on my original one, I put some washes of desert cactus on here, just in random places. So we're going to do that on here. Very sheer color. Don't get too carried away. And just pick some places to put some of this color. You can follow my picture and try and do some like I did on mine. It's really, you know, just kind of a hit and miss kind of thing. Putting some of this on there. But it's, again, like everything else I've been doing on here, it's a very sheer color. So don't make it too dark. You'll be sad if you make it too dark. Okay, I'm just going to pick some of these. And just let your imagination go. Okay, I think that might be pretty good. Let's put a little bit up on the tip of that one so we can see a little bit better. Some of these tips in the background, I can't really see them too much. And that's kind of the way it was on my original one. But once I varnished it, they all just popped forward, let me tell you. Okay, so just a few random places like I did here. Right here on these leaves. Here. And it can be in the middle. It doesn't have to all be on the outer edges, so you could put some, you know, next to the centers there. Okay. So that's looking pretty good. I still think I need a little bit more of the highlight on a few places. So I am going to take a liner brush and just bring some of that in, maybe. Just bring a touch of that back in there. I feel like when I put that second coat of yellow hands on there, I feel like I lost a lot of my white. I'm just going to drag it out a little bit. That's a little bit too much right there on both of those, so I'll touch that back here with some yellow. Okay, that is looking super good. Right, I just want to take that down just a scooch. Some of that yellow. A couple of these are a little bit too bright. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Don't forget to go over on your bud here. I just about did. Almost forgot. Add a little bit of green in here. Yeah, just random. Okay, just a little bit of green over there too. Okay, your mop brush, I use it dry, in case you wonder if you've never painted with me before. I like to clean it off, see all that paint that's in it, on a damp place on the paper towel. And then if I don't have a dry spot, I go to a dry paper towel and just dry it off. You don't want to wash it because it'll take a little while to dry. So now it's ready to go for the next color. So if you don't wash it off, you will transfer that color onto another place on your project, and then you'll just be like, where did that color come from? So you won't be too happy. I see a place I need shade up here with that burnt umber and orange twist mix. So this petal comes over this one. Okay, so we kind of needed to have that clarified there. A little bit of white on the tip. Okay, I think we're looking pretty good here. Let's begin on our center now. So, the base coat of the center, I think I just... let me find my instructions here. Soft black. Soft black. So just if you've got some kind of scruffy brush that you can tap it in with, I think that's all I did. This is a scruffy brush that I use wet, so I'm just gonna, and that's not near big enough, so let me get a bigger one. You can just use a flat brush and kind of tap it in there as well. We just want to put some color in here. And don't let it take over your... a little too much water here. Don't let it take over your flower. want to go out on our petals a little bit, but we don't want to cover up all that beautiful work that we did on our petals. So just slap some soft black in there. Don't. I have way too much water on mine, so I'm going to have to go dry it now. Okay, so while this center is starting to dry, let me wide angle out. I want to darken this down here with a wash of burnt orange. So, a much larger brush you might need for doing this. So I'm just going to get a large filbert brush. Flat brush will work just fine. Angle brush, whatever you want to do, because I'm just going to side load it anyway. And I want this to be a little damp, so I am going to spritz it a little bit. That might be a little bit too damp. And then I'm just going to side load my brush with burnt orange. That's the color we put down here. And just kind of add some of this color down in here. I really want this to be a little bit more brighter of a color. Soften those edges. Mop brush. And take it up a little bit up the side. Use my mop brush. Soften that out. Just use a wash of color because you don't want to cover up your modeling that you have back there. But this needs to be just a little bit darker. So just darken it up just a little bit. Now you'll want to get that dry. If you've got a small fan, go ahead and dry it so you don't lay your arm in it as we're working on the center or anything. Clean my mop brush here. And then wash my big brush out. And then we're going to get ready to start on the centers. I think mine's dry. So I'm going to take a pencil, so if I find it. Okay, let me zoom you back in here. Okay, so in my painting here, my original one, we've got an outer circle, and we've got an inner circle. So you can lay the pattern back on and put your circle on there if you want. It's a little wet, so hopefully a little bit of paint on me. I am going to draw a circle in the center here. Okay, just right in the center. Make it look like a donut, a big donut. That's what you're going to do. Okay, I've drawn my circle in here. Let me zoom in. We're going to start working on the center of the flower now. I've got a small angled scruffy brush. I like to use this for foliage, but I'm going to be using it for the center here. This is a royal one, but I sell some Low Cornell brand of these as well. So I did dampen the brush. I've got cactus green on my brush, and the inner circle, we want to tap some of this in here. Now we still want to see some of that soft black. By the time we get done, we won't see a whole lot of it, but we still want to see it in there. Alright, then I'm going to take a paper towel and pull out the excess paint out of my brush and go into some Sunny Day, the same brush. And we'll begin tapping some of this in here. Okay, we'll wipe that off. And we'll get a small round brush for our next step. Let's see. Howler Dark Green is our next color. So I spritz my palette with some water in case I need some. We want to go in here and now just start tapping some of this color in here. I think the seeds grow on the outside part, but I'm not 100% sure on that. So we're going to tap this Hauser Dark Green in here. I'm just going to wipe my brush off and go into some olive green. And start tapping this in. Now, if you feel like you're covering up any of your colors underneath, like our sunny day, we're going to be adding some more yellow in here. You can tap some of that in, or your cactus green. Go back to my olive green here. Tap some of that in. Okay. And then bright yellow. And tap that in. This is kind of a more transparent color, so it won't show up as much. Might keep it more to the right side here. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit more olive green in here. And maybe just a touch more of the. This is where you just can do adjusting, and you're just doing little dots and dabs here. Okay, we'll need to let this dry before we can add any shading or anything down in the center here. Okay, so we're going to start on the outer edge here, and we're going to go back to our other brush. I'm going to wash it out. Try and get some of that excess water out of it. Back to this little scruffy brush here. Pick up some burnt umber. I'm going to tap some of this in. Around the outer. Don't cover up all your soft black. Okay, if you go over onto your flower, it's not going to hurt a thing. We need that to kind of come on over it. Okay, I'm going to clean that brush out. Okay, on the outside here, even though I tapped that burnt umber in with my other brush, I still want to put a little bit around in here. And all over. I know you probably can't even see this color on camera. So this is how we're going to put all the color in around the outside edge. We are going to tap. Little taps. Like we did in the center. They must be controlled, not sloppy. Don't make them blend together. You want to retain every color that you put on here. Okay, so I'm going to wipe off my brush and go into some, what's my next color? Golden Straw. And I'm going to begin tapping this on here. I Some of those were kind of big. We'll go right up to our line there. This will go all the way around. That burnt umber just barely shows up on there. It's just like little polka dots, but you don't want to lay your brush flat and get, you know, flat ones. You want to kind of stay up on the tip of the brush and make sure your paint is fresh. That will help. If you've got paint that's been sitting on there for a while, it won't do as well. So I'm just going back through and tapping in a few more. Okay, got called away there for a second, so this is probably completely dry. I'm just wiping my brush off with the golden straw, and now I'm loading some sunny day yellow on my brush, and we're going to add some of this color in here. Remember, you want dots. And I might come back in and add a little bit more golden straw back in here so we can have some of that more gold color. So this is going to be a layering process. And you can get it to look however looks most appealing to you. And your seeds can kind of come out, you know, off of this circle. Don't confine them into here. I call them seeds, but they're not technically seeds. The seeds are underneath this part. So the center all, this part would eventually be closed over. So this part out here, depending on how big your sunflower is, the center could be way out here. But there's this part that covers the seeds, and the seeds are underneath this part, if that makes any sense. So this is what lays on top of the seeds to protect them and help them become what they, little seeds that we like to eat. Okay, I'm going to wipe my brush off and go back into my golden straw. I want to put a little bit more of this back in here. I started having my brush kind of on the side. Don't have it this way. You need to have it straight up and down so you can get those dots on there. Our center's dry, and I might have to go back in and add a little bit more color back into the center. So if we bring this color out, we're not going to see it a whole lot. So I'm going to wipe my brush off. I'm going to load a little bit of sunny day yellow on my brush, then wipe it off so that we can dirty brush into our next color, which is bright yellow. And so we'll add some of this in here. I believe that's our next color. Maybe I better check. Yeah. I should read my instructions instead of just making stuff up, huh? So this is just a layering process. You don't want to cover up your brown completely. And I'm going to keep this color a little bit more, maybe towards the, on this side, more towards the center, because that's where the light will be hitting, and then we'll have reflected over here. So we'll put this yellow all the way over here. And I'm going to come back in and add some more golden straw. I can already see that it just does not have enough golden straw for me. So I'm going to keep adding that in there until I feel like it looks good. I could probably add some yellow ochre in there too. It's a little bit of a darker color. I mean a more muted color. So this is yellow ochre. I'm not sure that even says that in my instructions. So you can add that in if you want. Just a little bit of this. I'll wipe it off. Go back into my golden straw. And so I'm just going to keep doing this until I have it. I don't want all of my soft black completely covered, but I do want my colors, you know, to be distinct. Okay, now I'm going to go into my, I always wipe off the excess of the previous color before I go into my next color. Just keep working it up and down. Brush straight up and down. No, it doesn't look like much now. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit more of the bright yellow. Then we're going to go back in and add a little bit of burnt umber in here. I'm barely touching my brush down, just leaving little bits of paint here. But it's exactly the same way that we did the center. I'm going to take this bright yellow and go in here and add a little bit more. Okay, now I think I'm going to add some burnt umber and maybe a little bit of olive green in the outer section here. So I'm going to wash my brush off. I'm going to start with my burnt umber. Add some of this in here. You can just keep working this until you've got it how you like it. Make it loose, not tight. I'm going to wash my brush off and get some olive green now. Now, if you don't have a scruffy brush to do the center, the very center, like we did, you can just do it all with this type of brush. Just dotting it in instead of doing the scruffy part. The scruffy part just makes it a little bit faster. I don't want a whole lot of this in here. Just a little bit. All right, I'm going to go back to some of my yellows in here. Sunny day, I think. And just, you know, however you like the look of it is when you can stop. Okay, a little bit of my bright yellow back in here. And then we've got to let this dry completely before we can do any shading and highlighting on it. This is my bright yellow. I'm keeping it right through here, and then on this side, the whole side of it. I'm going to tap a little bit more. Oops. All this green down in here. And just a tiny bit more of our black green, our Hauser dark green. And then I feel like we completely lost any of our soft black that was down in the center, which is okay. On my original, I don't have a whole lot of it showing, but I just feel like we need to see a little bit of it down in here. So I'm just going to put a little bit in here, some random kind of places, keeping it mostly on this side. This is the side we're going to shade. Okay, that is looking pretty good. I'm liking how that looks. So as soon as you are happy with how your little dots are on there, then you can be done with it. And my instructions have to shade and highlight on here, but you have to wait till it is dry before you do that. So while that is drying, we are going to base coat in our stems and leaves. And let me find my base coat colors. The leaves will be based with desert cactus and the stem as well. So we're just going to put everything in desert cactus. I'll go off camera and do that because it's just simple base coating. Whatever brush you like that will fit the project. Two coats of desert cactus. Alright, I've got all my base coating on for my green there. So this is completely dry up here. So we're going to get our shading and highlighting done on there. I'm going to have to adjust my instructions because as I was reading them, I had them backwards. So we're going to take Hauser Dark Green, and we are going to load our brush with a float side load. I have something in my paint here. Okay, let me bring my palette up here. So I am starting out with a little bit of a sheer float here. So I've got a little bit of water in there. I'm working it in my brush, so it's a little sheer. I'll probably come back and repeat this, but I want to start out this way. So we're going to go inside the center here, and we're going to walk it in a little bit. Okay. I'm going to do just a tiny little bit on this other side. Just keep it right there against that. Not too much. Not too much. Okay, now we're going to go with our soft black. And we'll load it the same way so it's a little more sheer. And we will go on the outside of this one. A little bit too much paint. Let me get kind of make it jaggedy on the edge so it doesn't look like a straight line across there. So kind of tap it in and, you know, let it come out past a little bit. That's okay. And bring it up. Okay, we'll come back and repeat that. And then on this other side, we are going to do along here. And we can take a little bit of this soft black down in here. Okay, now we're starting to get some depth going on there. We're going to have to come back and repeat this side, but it's still pretty wet. So let's get our highlight color out, which is bright yellow to start with. So we're going to use our bright yellow on our bright areas. But I want to add a little bit more of this burnt umber on here real quick. I'll go ahead and do this side as well. Fling it off my easel here. Okay, now for a highlight here. I'm going to do bright yellow. So you don't have to have this as washy because this bright yellow is more sheer. So I'm going to go along this edge, brighten that up, and we'll go along here. So you're doing opposites of each other. We need to let that dry a little bit. We're going to shade, while that's drying, we're going to shade around this on the flower petals. We'll do that with our golden straw and orange twist mix. So, just brush mix that. I'm going to try equal amounts here and see how that looks. And I think we need to be darker, so let's change that up. Let's add a little bit of burnt umber maybe in that mix. I need it to be a little bit darker. So I'll change that on my instructions. Let's see how this works out. I don't like that. That's a little bit too too chalky looking for me. Okay. Let's try our our shading color that we did back in here, which was our burnt umber and our orange twist. So burnt umber and orange twist. I'm going to use two orange twists and one burnt umber. So let's try this color. That's much better. I think I'll add a little bit more burnt umber in there, so we could do about equal amounts. Keep this kind of choppy and irregular. Don't go for any kind of smooth line here. On the highlight side, it won't need to be as wide of a float. So it will need to be on the shaded side. A little water here. Okay, that looks much better. Alright, let's go do our highlight. Again, I'm going to put some white out just in case I need to lighten that yellow a little bit. So that's our bright yellow. And it goes up here. And it goes right here. Tiny bit of white on my brush here and just mix it in. And put a little bit of that. Should wait for that to dry though. I don't want any really opaqueness on here because I want to be able to see all my little dots and stuff going on there. Let's not let this get too much on the white side, so if you feel like it is, just put some more of that bright yellow over it. You can just leave the white off completely unless you feel like you need it, because it's very, you know, it will cause a little bit more opaqueness than what I want your center to have. I'm going to put a little bit of this bright yellow down here in the center. Kind of just brighten that up just a little bit on this side. And then I feel like the burnt umber needs to be widened. Or the soft black, not the burnt umber. So you adjust your project to your liking. This is how you get your touch in there. Oops. Let me take my mop brush here. Kind of blend that down a little bit. I think we're done with our center. I'm going to wide angle out so you can see it a little bit better. So that looks pretty good for our center. Got my base coat on for my leaves. So I think we'll go work on leaves next. So hopefully I can do this without this falling off my easel here constantly. So let me zip in here a little bit. Okay, so for all of our shading, we're going to go with some how's our dark green? Use the brush that you feel comfortable using. We are going to create some center veins in here. Our leaves. And then this one has a turned edge. And this one has a little bit of a turned edge. I think that's all the turned edges that I have there. So, and then up here, if you need to, you can do your separations for your which one is where, so you know who's on top and who's not. Alright, so Hauser dark green. Use the brush that you like to float with. I am going to float with a flat brush like I've been using on this project so far. But most of you know that have painted on my videos or watched my videos that curve flat is my favorite brush. So we want to start by darkening up at the base of these. Okay, while I'm doing this, it's erasing my line. I put those lines in there so you could see what I would be doing. But I know where I'm going to be going, so I don't have to worry so much about those lines. This one here. And we'll bring it down a little bit. And this one here. I took my water edge there and removed a little bit of that paint because a little bit too much of a hard line for me. And then our big leaf here. A little bit more paint. Bring it all the way up here. Try and keep it off my leaves here. It's going to come all the way underneath this curved edge. I have to get my mop brush. I'm going to have to mop that and kind of soften it back. That one's going to take more work because it's bigger, so we got to bring that float out a little bit. So see, like on my big one, my original one, I brought it out quite a bit here. So let's add our wolf shading underneath this turned out place. Take the water edge and soften that out. I'm going to wash my brush off because the paint has gotten over much farther on my brush than I would like for it to be. That's dry, so let's try and bring that out a little bit. So, if you are not comfortable bringing a wide float out, you can pre-dampen the area, and that will help. Lay some paint in here. Take my mop brush and then soften and blend it. Okay, so that gets it going into that leaf a little bit. We're going to go around every one of our petals there, but I need that to dry before we do that. So I'm going to let that dry. Okay, I'm going to a smaller flat brush here to shade on the stuff here. Just a little bit more here. Okay, we want to shade next to that I'm gonna bring that down a little bit. Okay, we're gonna go, let's see, we're gonna go down this side. Around that petal. Picking up water and paint, blending them on my brush. Laying my brush flat, gentle pressure. All the way down. I'll kind of widen that just a little bit. So I'm going to pick up a little bit more paint on my brush. Now this one over here I did a little bit different on my original, but I want this to be dark along this lower edge here. That's not very straight, so let me see if I can straighten that up. My original one I didn't make quite that fat, and to be honest with you, sunflowers, one flower to one stalk. Don't normally see an extra flower coming off of a stalk, but you know, creative liberties as an artist, you can create how appeals to you. So let's add in our veining with this brush. It's all on the lower sides of these leaves. I want to go around my petals up here on this big one. This is, you know, as you paint this green in on your leaf, you can shape your petals. So if you've got an end on a petal that you don't like, then you can shape it very easily. When you're basing your green or with this shading around them. Come back and repeat on the shading here. We also want to shade on the turn edge here. And on the other one. Here. The vein in it. I'll put some of this on this one. And darken up here. That whole section right in there will be dark. Alright, so we can see if there's any place on here that we want to intensify our shading. Like this one I feel like needs a little bit more back here. Let's see. Let's just, on our turn places, let's just go in and add a little bit more in here. Make it look a little more lifted up off of the leaf. This one needs to come down just a little bit more. All right, I'm going to put a little bit more down this stem here. I'm going to load it a little bit farther over on my brush. Oops. Trying to get a little bit smoother side here, not so raggedy. And canvases can tend to pull a little bit on the paint, which is good when you want that look, but I'm trying to straighten up my stem here. It's a little cattywampus here. That's a lot better. All right, let's put our vein in our big one up here. So we're going to follow. Well, that's a little crooked, so let me erase that. Try that again. Give that another try. There, that looks much better. Now, technically, veining on sunflower leaves has veins that come out on the sides like this. And I didn't do this on my original one. So it really just depends on how much detail you want on your leaves. But if you want to shade them, brush out. If you want to add the veining, which I'll add it on this project, but on my original one, I did not add the veining. So it is completely up to you. I'll just put a note in my instructions that the veining is shaded just like you shade the other. So let's see. No, let's shade on the other side. Let me reload my brush here. So we'll shade on this edge. And then we can have one kind of wrapping around this one if you want. Not necessary, but Okay, and on this little bitty one here, we can put a couple. I have most of the water out of my brush. So I'm just kind of, let me add some on this one. And then this one would come up. Let's see. Let's give it a little bit of angle distraction. So, we're still just using our Hauser dark green here. We haven't gone to any other color yet. So I'm going to put this on the lower sides. We're going to have to go around those petals again. It's not quite dark enough there. And on here. Okay, that's all with our black green. I'm going to get my little bit of bigger brush here. So I can go around that and darken it. So if you have done your shading a little bit lighter, now is the time to go back and repeat it and get a second shading on there. Okay, that's looking good. Looking good. Okay, we're going to start highlighting, so I'm going to erase my lines that I drew in here. Get them out of the way. So they aren't distracting. Brush away from your paint. Let's add some highlights on here. We're going to start with some olive green. I love this olive green. Now it goes on rather bright, and you're probably thinking, oh my goodness, what have I done? But it really does fade back down in there. Now we're going to go beside the center line. We're not going to start all the way back here like we did with the dark line. We're kind of just doing the center of it. Okay, just keep going on every leaf. We're going to work on the tips first and down our center vein. Oops, opposite side of. So I think I'll go and do the center veins real quick. I'm up on the very tip of this brush, almost lining that vein. And then this one will just have a little bit of that peeking through there. Not too much. Keep on keeping on here. Okay. The edge of this one, this big one here. Here. Bring that down. Use the water edge to kind of soften that. Now let's do our veining. So we're going to go on the opposite side. Kind of in the center, like you did on the center vein. And you see how much that's already faded back down in there? You can get your liner brush out for this if it's easier for you. Let's go on this big one here. All right, we're going to go down the stems. Start on this one down here. And pull it up. Okay, these leaves are looking pretty good. Alright, we're going to repeat with a color we haven't used on here yet. And after we use it on the leaves, I'm going to put a little bit in the center here. It's similar to olive green, but it's much brighter. It's called Chartreuse Yellow. It's one of the colors that came out in 2016. And there it is. There's olive green, and there's that one. So you can see it's got a little bit more yellow in it. So we're just going to brighten some of our highlights with this color. Before I do that, on my original one, because I didn't do the veining in this one, I kind of dragged some of the yellow in there, so I am going to do that with this. I'm going to take my olive green and just pull a little bit of this in here for some highlight in that one. I'm going to pull it down on this just a little bit. Drag it in there. Now we're going to go to our chartreuse yellow. This is a very pretty color. So we're just going to add some, a little bit of this color on here. Create a little bit more brightness. And you don't want to cover up all of your olive green, so just add it in random places. I need to darken that. Edge here, out here. I'm going to put just a touch of this along the center. Right here. I'm just going to go in the center part of that. And the same with this down here. I'm just kind of let it fade out down there. And then work it along this edge. Kind of let it fade away right there. And we'll do just a little bit on some of our veins. Just like in the center of those. Oops. Get some paint on my brush here. And again, you can do this with a liner brush. You know, you can't get a thin enough line up on that. I'm going to wipe my paint off and then put a little bit of this in here. These are looking pretty good. Now, I want to add some of this chartreuse yellow up here. So I'm just going to side load a little bit of it. And kind of float some in the center here. Just kind of pick up a little bit of that more yellow color. You could put some out here as well. Just the very edge. Like it there. I got too much white there. I have to go back and add some bright yellow on that. Much better. A couple little dibby dabs of bright yellow in there. Okay. Let's see where we go from here. Let's see. I want to deepen a little bit here. Some of my shading. Just want to make sure that these turned edges looked turned. Okay, those are looking pretty good. I want to add a little bit of, I don't have this in my instructions, but I want to add a little bit of the yellow, the Hansa yellow light. See how that looks on our leaves, just in a couple of places. So we'll just do some random stuff with this. I'm just gonna try and do the places where it would be the brightest. All right, put some on the stem, just in the very center there, and on this one. I really like that. That looks good. Let's add our stems on here. Let's see. I'm going to take some Hauser dark green. I think that's what I did them all with. And thin it down a little bit with some water so it will flow off of my liner brush nicely. And then just come in here and add your veins. Or your stems. Hook them. Hook your leaves onto your stem. Everything on a sunflower kind of starts falling over and drooping down, and that includes the leaves. So, just pull them right in to where you created that center vein. This one right here, I'm going to go back and take some of that Hansa yellow, that media paint, and if you're not using the media paint, you can use bright yellow. Just a little. This won't show up too much on here, but I definitely want some on the stem. Alright, so any, let me wide angle out a little bit. Any of your graphite lines that you still have on there, you're going to want to remove. And you can look at your project. Right now would be a good time to look at it and or step away from it for a moment and then come back to it and see if there's any places that you need to fix or brighten up. And I put some white paint on there. Let that dry just a little bit. Now I'm going to come back with some yellow, some of that Hansa yellow. Okay. Put a little bit more of this yellow up here. And I think I want to darken some of mine. Now, if you cannot get your shading with the Hauser dark green to be as dark as you would like, then you can add a tiny little bit of soft black in there. I do that a lot, so make sure darker color is a little bit darker. Alright, just give it a look over, see what you think, see if you need any more highlights or shading on there. I'm going to erase the graphite lines that I did not paint over. As long as I haven't put any paint on them, they're going to come right off. Alright, that's looking pretty good. I mean, look, compared to my original one, they're pretty close. Pretty close. Different size canvases. This one's been varnished, so everything looks a little bit darker. It looks like I might have tapped a little bit of the yellow ochre up in here. So, because that one looks a little bit more on the yellowy orange side. And this one doesn't, so that you can do that when you are sponging on your background. Alright, we're going to get ready to stencil on the bottom here. Alright, the first thing we want to do when we add our word down here is to draw a line across here so we have a straight place to put our stencil. Now, my stencils are clear so that I can see exactly where I'm putting them on my surface. So that is the reason I made mine clear, because I always had a little bit of trouble telling where my stencil was at. You know, what it was on top of. I mean, I really had to look hard to see where it was at. So, this stencil is on my website. It's got both sizes. This one will fit 11 by 14, and this one is the canvas I'm working on. What size is it? It's a 9 by 12. So, this one will fit a 9 by 12 or an 8 by 10, and this one will fit an 11 by 14 or a larger size if you want to go to a larger size. It's just it will look smaller on there. So, this is how the larger one looks on the 11 by 14. Okay, so we're going to take a makeup sponge, and we're going to use this to stencil in, and I use my makeup sponges till there's nothing. Once it's got paint on it and I'm done with it, I lay it on its side, let the paint dry, cut it off so that I don't get paint on my scissors. You can cut it off wet, but I'd rather not clean my scissors every time I use them. And then I just keep cutting it off and I use it until it's done. So I've got a little bit of smaller one in here, not quite as small as that other one. And we are going to stencil in with soft black. So when you load your makeup sponge, you want to pick up a little bit of paint and then go over here and tap it off on your palette. And that kind of disperses it on the sponge. These are not very absorbent, so paint will not go up in them. It's going to stay mostly right on that edge. So you don't want to have too much paint on there. It's going to bleed under your stencil. Okay, now you can use a stencil brush. You can use a fingertip dauber like this, which I also sell on my website. I love using those. If you have one of these inking things, you can use it. So there are a variety of ways that you can put the paint on with a stencil. Okay, I'm going to move this over just a little bit because my S is too close to the edge over there. Get your letters, the bottom edge of your letters, right on that line that you painted. Okay, don't worry about the S. It's these letters that you need to line up. Okay, make sure you've got about the same distance over here on each side, and then just start straight up and down. Don't swirl it or push it or mush it. Straight up and down. If you don't get enough coverage the first time, you can repeat it. But you need to always go straight up and down. Load it the same way, pick up a little bit, tap it. Even though my stencil is taped, I'm still holding it in place to make sure it doesn't bounce around and, you know, get off with the alignment. I just pick up a little bit of paint at a time. Straight up and down. Now I will repeat this and then we'll take this off. Oops. And all right, straight up and down. I want it to be a little bit more opaque here. First coat is never enough for me, but if you like that more softening and, you know, gradation of color, then you can just do it the one time. That will be perfectly fine. Straight up and down. Not too much paint. Oops. Did that last time too. Okay, I'm going to lift it up so we can see how it looks. Looks pretty good. So now, if you want your letters to connect, like in this one, I wanted my letters to connect. So all the places that were open spaces, or what they call bridges for a stencil, I went in with my liner brush and took my soft black. And this one is a little bit kind of messy on the edges, so I'm going to straighten it up. You have to have a little bit of water in your paint so it's inky consistency. So right here where there is a gap, let me zoom in here, where there's a gap in your letter, you can just join that and get rid of that little gap there. Straighten up this edge a little bit. Okay, another place that there is a gap in my letters. This letter is a little messy as well, so I'm going to straighten up the edge, or try to. Is right here. So I'm going to bring that down, and this one. And my O. These are called bridges. And your stencils. And so I'm just going to join all of those together so that I have none of those gaps in there. And then you can take your liner brush or your round brush and touch up any place that you feel needs to be touched up. You'll erase your line that you drew on there. Check it, see how you like it. Get my stuff over here, and we will get both of these up here so you can see them together. My original one and the one that I just painted for this video. So here is wide angle out a little bit more. Here's my original one, and here's the one that I just painted. So in this one, it's much bigger. I brought my yellow up a little bit higher into this and put just a tiny bit in the background up there. But I like this one, the way the background is on this one at the top. This one has a glare on it because it really makes the sunflower pop more. It brings it out more. So it's really personal preference there. But everything else, the same colors. I only added the veining on this one. So when you get done, I want you to let it set for just a minute. Step away from it. Walk away. Sometimes I will put it across the room and set it and then look at it from a distance. I will take pictures of it and look at it and see if there's any adjusting or corrections that I need to make to it. So if you don't feel like your flower is quite as yellow as you would like it to be, if it got a little bit too brown looking, which is when the sunflowers are on their last leg, when they're about ready to be picked, all of the petals will turn brown and fall off. So you can just wash over it with some of that Hansa yellow light in the media paint, or some bright yellow. One of those would be okay, or cad yellow. We didn't use cad yellow in this project, so in place of the Hansa yellow light, I used bright yellow, so which is a little more on the yellow side. This is a little bit more on the white side, so. But this is a more transparent color, and this will be a little more opaque, so you'll really have to thin that down to use it as a wash or a glaze. So there we have this project. It is completed. I hope that you enjoyed painting it with me. I loved painting this and designing it, being a girl from Kansas. You know, sunflower is the state flower, and I just think it turned out beautiful. So thank you for painting with me, and I will see you guys on the next one.